is Saleena Jawad, and I will be presenting my project, which is the IOT Temperature and Humidity application. The REU site that I was at for this program was Morgan State University, although I'm originally from Hampton University. My goal for this project was to create a cheap and efficient temperature humidity system that should alert the user of any changes in the temperature or humidity of a room. Now, using this application, the user should be notified of any changes, and they should also be able to view the history of the environmental conditions of the room. I wanted to make this system to monitor the changes in a specific room, and, you know, there's already things like a thermostat in most buildings, but it doesn't quite keep every room at the set conditions. For example, when I worked IT for the city of Alexandria, there were two rooms with this particular issue, that being the back room that I worked in, which had all of the equipment, and so the door stayed locked and closed with only key card access. The problem with that is, with all of the computers that we would be imaging overnight, there was no way to tell if the room was going to be too hot for the computers, which also continued to add heat themselves. Now, that, as opposed to the server room, which had to stay at a lovely 50 degrees, they're just two entirely different biomes. But if the server room were to get too humid or too hot, the servers would be in obvious danger. You know, that's the data for the entire city. So, aside from that, the office space was actually between these two rooms, and the thermostat would only report and change the conditions of the office space. So my project goal is to notify when the back room is too hot or the server room is too hot, even though the office space would feel perfectly fine. So I mentioned IoT, and that is actually the Internet of Things, which is quite simple. It's basically just taking things and connecting them to the Internet to limit human interactivity for certain tasks. For this project, I used Arduino, which has boards like the Arduino Uno or Arduino Nano, but I used the ESP32 board, but I did still use the Arduino program to code my ESP32. The language that Arduino, the program, uses is closer to JavaScript, which is great because that's where most of my experience comes in. The ESP32 board is a Wi-Fi-enabled microcontroller. It's also Bluetooth-enabled as well. And, you know, there are existing systems out there with capabilities of, you know, monitoring the temperature and humidity, and even changing the temperature of a specific room when it isn't within the desired range, but they're typically a lot more expensive than the solution that I want to come up with. I began my research by finding the needed materials and gathering useful code, but as you can see on this slide, the circuitry is as simple as I could make it. I started with the ESP32 board, and then I added the DHT11, which is a temperature humidity sensor, and I later decided to also include the LCD display module to display the temperature and the humidity in real time, so it could display the current conditions of wherever the device is located. I would like to later also implement a time module as well to display the real time and date on the LCD display. So one of the hardest things for me was I knew nothing about networking and Wi-Fi when I began my research, but I had to get that together in order to attempt to put my device on the internet. Although I was only able to connect this to my laptop via the router, which had no internet, I was still able to get a web server going, which led me to learn a little bit of web design because I had a website through the web server. And other than that, my biggest challenge was teaching myself with the vocabulary that I was unfamiliar with, because, you know, as soon as I found the answer to any of my questions, I didn't know what it was talking about because I was unfamiliar also with the terminology that was used to explain what my problem was. So moving forward, I would really like to get my device uploaded with ThingSpeak, which can display the history, the graphs, the charts, and, you know, my data would also be secure, and I would like to link it to my website and hopefully secure that website as well. I would like to make this as mobile as possible, my device, so I would be adding a battery. The results. Both the LCD and the website display the current temperature and humidity of the room which the device is located. And with the coding, I was able to get the ESP32 board to display the IP address and the MAC address, which is very useful for trying to get it connected to any internet, anything at all. So, although the school internet had a security protocol that wouldn't allow my device to connect to the internet, after days and days of trying to connect it, we came to find that my code was actually fine, and the ESP board, it was fine, but because, you know, the board actually connected to the internet at my house, just not the internet at school. So I did end up obtaining a code for ThingSpeak, but debugging it was difficult, and I simply didn't have the time to implement the function due to the time spent in my attempts to try to get it on the internet at school. But moving forward, going forward, I would really like to use ThingSpeak as my cloud storage for keeping my data, and I'd like to start on a phone application and a web application that notifies the user and also displays the current temperature and humidity, but also will have graphs and charts to display the history of the room's environment. As for security, I would like to improve on the security on the website. I was looking into Bro and other security protocols for the application and the device, such as encryption. I want to also include mesh networking. That function would be very useful for the device. That way, if one device is out of range for Wi-Fi, for the Wi-Fi connection, it still would just connect to one of the closer devices, the ones that were closer